welcome
to the Daftunks.
Back again.
We're back, everybody. I'm Ashton.
I'm Tucker. Collectively, the Daftunks.
True.
This is Jennifer's Body by Hole.
By Hole, yeah. Courtney Love's band.
Courtney Love's band.
Yeah, and so there's a lot of connections for why we're talking about this track specifically.
Get into it. Give it what? Yeah.
So, one, Jennifer's Body is the name of the track.
Yeah.
Jennifer B, if you will.
I Love You, Jennifer B is the name of this album we're talking today.
And that's by a band called Jockstrap. And then this song is
how
by
does
a
Jockstrap
band called Hole.
Yeah.
So, you know, those are kind of similar
I love
to a
you,
degree.
Jennifer's Body.
But yeah, we're talking about I Love You, Jennifer B, by Jockstrap, a.k.a. Georgia Ellery and Taylor Sky.
Yeah.
Art pop duo.
Yeah, young art pop
Young up and
Brits.
Comers. Yeah, no, this is their debut album, even.
Yeah, debut album.
We'd love to talk a debut.
There's been a few EPs. I think we've, like, collectively, like,
yeah, I'm
been
a big
like,
Wicked City goes.
Okay.
For sure.
Yeah.
And
wasn't
then,
there, like, an Injury Reserve collab?
Yeah,
there's
that was that's
stuff.
On Wicked City.
I love I Want Another Affair.
Okay.
There's some great tracks.
Yeah.
Yeah, that old Love is the Key to the City. Yeah.
That's a good one. Joy on there is a good track.
Yeah.
My favorite of their releases, honestly, is they dropped a remix EP, I think it was last year, maybe 2020, called Beaver Core.
Sick.
And there's just, like, it's half piano ballads and half, like, insane remixes.
Yeah. Okay.
So listen to that if you've never listened.
Fascinating little group.
Yeah.
Shout out, Georgia Ellery, obviously, of Black Country New Road.
Yeah, and I didn't even know that when I first was listening to Jockstrap.
Yeah, I mean, I guess she's, like, the main pianist in Black Country
Violinist
New Road.
Violinist as well.
I think I've seen some YouTube leaks of their recent live shows.
Yeah.
Since, like, Isaac's not in the band
we
anymore.
We are exactly 2 weeks out from seeing him live.
Yeah,
so.
We're going to see Black Country / Black MIDI. But, no, she's doing a lot of, like, vocals as well.
That's exciting, because I do really like her vocals across this album.
We'll
spoiler
get to see.
Alert. Spoiler alert about our thoughts on the album.
So, yeah, one thing about this album is the vocals are good.
Fuck, yeah, I just spoiled everything.
You just spoiled our whole takes. That,
that was
rehearsed.
The take that we had for our next hour.
But, yeah, excited to talk this. I think, like, an interesting debut album from a
100%
from a duo.
This album cover might be my favorite of the year. Obviously very simple.
There's, like, a green version as well.
Okay,
which is pretty sick.
Yeah, but I just simple like sticker
white.
On some sticker on a
jog
white wall.
Jockstrap sticker.
Jockstrap. I'd throw that on the back of my
such
car.
Such a wild band name as well. Just a.
Oh, actually, I've got a little. I just bought a Home Is Where. But we talk about this band, a bumper sticker, and I'm going to put it on the screen. It goes hard as fuck.
Is it on your car?
It's not on there yet,
okay.
But it's on the way.
You have
it's
a white car.
So I've got a white car.
It's going to look similar to this
album
cover.
Exactly, yeah. It's a longer sticker.
I love just one single sticker.
Yeah.
Home Is Where sticker.
Yeah, exactly. It's something about you're a pussy if you don't listen to Fifth Wave Emo or something like that.
And that's your whole belief system.
It really is, Fifth Wave Emo and Jockstrap.
I don't even know how I would classify this genre.
I was looking at Pitchfork. Spoiler alert, this is Best New Music.
Wow.
But you look through these other albums here, and they each have, like, Beyonce is pop and R&B.
Yeah.
That Florist album, which was good as well. That's folk country, etc. You get to Jockstrap over here, they're like, we don't know how to categorize
what
this.
What is electronic?
Electronic, experimental, pop, and R&B. We'll throw four things on there.
Yeah.
We're not sure, okay?
No, I would say a lot of pop, a lot of, also very experimental.
Oh, 100%. It'll take you aback at points where you're not
almost
even
hyper poppy
it.
At times, like, you know.
Oh yeah, it's 2022.
It's sick. But it's just interesting to see this other side of like the refined, like, Black Country New Road, like, piano parts.
100%.
And then this is a fascinating other side of it. You want to go into it?
Let's do it.
Let's go into track one, Neon.
Neon.
I Love You, Jennifer B.
Yeah, shout out Jennifer B.
Yeah, for real.
And Jennifer's Body. I have to assume they're talking about, what, Jenny from the Block?
Isn't that a movie? I feel like someone told me that.
Jennifer B?
Or
I Love
Body.
You. Oh, probably. We're not.
Let's just say probably.
Let's just say probably and then listen to this tune.
Folkio intro.
So this is pretty much what the whole album sounds like. Just like some good, like, guitar and, like, soft-spoken vocals.
What's that one?
What?
The Something Newsome. That
Joanna Newsom. Yeah, this is I think that's how that album is.
Yeah.
She's got, like, a cello though. But then these.
Yeah,
like
sick.
Those digital drums right off the bat.
Yeah, just like classic influences, but in a 2022 lens.
Yeah, exactly.
Strings / drum machine. Sick. Hold that. Just like the spooky sounding guitars, sort of.
Oh yeah, slow strum. So their drums come in.
Yeah.
You can hear like just like pulsating synths in the background too. Yeah. Yeah.
Almost like a Arab Strap type.
Oh, true. Yeah. There was no way we weren't going to mention Arab Strap quickly in this episode.
It's the UK. It's
best album of last year.
Absolutely.
You know?
The turning of our...
As Days Get Dark is the name of the album.
Yeah. There's the piano, yeah. Ooh. But it isn't working.
Is it working? That's the whole chorus.
Yeah.
Is it working? It is. No, this drew me into the album immediately. Because, yeah. Like, you get drawn in by, like, this slow vocals, the slow, and then eruptive moment right here on track one.
Those, like, guitars.
Yeah, they're, like, grimy-ass guitars.
And the drums, too.
Yeah.
Like, grimy.
Just distorted as fuck.
That's a fun mix. And then just pretty piano over top.
Yeah, exactly. No, I mean, that's what... makes what I really love about Jockstrap's music is you have this contrast between these insanely beautiful moments and then you got grimy ass electronic instrumentation.
It's amazing.
Those vocals right there.
It's just an amazing voice.
But they're just like deep in the mix at the end here.
So essentially like Taylor is sort of behind a lot of the experimental production.
He's the electronic guy. And then I think any string you hear across here is our girl, George.
Or voice.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the outro on here. I won't do this again to you or to anyone. I won't do this again to myself over and over again.
I'm just picturing like them meeting. Like, I play like beautiful violin, piano.
I believe it's another classic story of met at art school.
I do grimy drums and insane electronics.
You know, it doesn't seem like this is gonna work, but maybe opposites attract. Shit.
That's very cool.
I was looking through like their I love it when artists post playlists on Spotify on their Spotify page. So I'd love to analyze those a little bit as well.
They got a playlist on here?
Yeah, they both got one for Georgia, or they each have two, actually.
Gotcha. Let's go into Georgia 1 here.
Yeah, let's take a look at Georgia 1 real quick as the outro of Neon.
Arctic Monkeys, Scott Walker.
Yeah, Scott Walker. And then obviously some Miley Cyrus as well. Roxy Music, Fat White Family, Ariana Grande.
Wise Blood.
It's all over the place. Yeah. Shout out that new Wise Blood song as well.
Sick. It's pretty sick.
And then Taylor, on the other hand.
What's Taylor got?
Ooh, I was actually just listening to this album by Salem.
Okay.
It's like Witch House is the genre.
Dancy?
It's heavy. It's going to be like shoegazy, but kind of dancy as well.
I should throw on some Salem.
No, listen to it. It was fire. If you know, do you know like Crystal Castles?
Oh, like that?
It's similar to Crystal Castles.
Yeah.
He's also got some Oniotrix Point Never in this playlist.
The first song is like a classical.
Oh piece. Yeah, no, this is very emblematic of their taste in music because this playlist also has Leonard Cohen on it, and then
Frank Ocean,
and Alice Coltrane. It's all over the place.
It's like the Black Country New Road playlist we went through that one time.
But yeah,
sick. Yeah,
that'll give you an idea.
Go
of what
check
them
out. Go check.
Go check out those playlists. There's
get,
more.
Get
on
some
there
education.
Too.
This is title track.
Title track. Jennifer B. Neon. Great opener. I really like that outro as it just repeated over and over again. And then we got some strange synth here to open us.
Something is tuned down.
Is that Jenny? We love you.
Jenny B?
Jenny B? Notification in the mix there. Weird.
It's like you're like outside of a club and like it starts
to
get
you're
louder.
Entering in. You're getting closer.
Honestly, a lot of this, I'll probably mention it later, but like a lot of MIA because we just talked about
recently. I was thinking that too on this track specifically, actually.
Scrappy beats.
All over the place beats that are from
siren.
Like around the world too.
Yeah. It's fancy.
Lots of elements here, but it's still going.
Yeah. Title track.
That's Jennifer that you're hearing right there.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh. Nice.
Just classic Jockstrap right there. Think you're getting a big like EDM build.
Yeah. This riff with these is crazy.
Synth.
Yeah.
Here's the intro on here. like a DJ, like a dancer. Your arms and legs covered in little white hairs.
Like a carpet.
No, like a mole hair sweater, I assume.
Okay.
That's sweet, baby, you smiled and said to me, as if I couldn't have said it any better.
Huh, okay. Ooh, I mean, so like MIA. Like...
It's also giving me, earlier in the year we talked about that FKA Twigs album, where she has similarly like soft-spoken vocals with like some heavy-ass beats.
Yeah.
Reminds me of some of the
epic.
Songs off,
like Capra this is like,
songs. Yeah.
I want to ride into the sunset.
And as the
dance
bass is
the
coming
sunset.
In, too.
Yeah. It's a wild cacophony.
It really is. Chorus on here. Just like some instructions. You got it. Flaunt it. Everything's good, girl.
Some weird samples here.
Oh, yeah.
Feel
you
your
got
ears
this,
for
this
sample.
Pretty chorus. Obviously, shifting about in her goddamn crochet pants, staring at God knows what.
Yeah. Sick. Oh, this is crazy. I mean, honestly, this was giving me like some sort of Billie Eilish vibes, honestly.
No, it's fair.
I mean, like the sort of... Ooh.
Definitely first album, Billie Eilish.
Yeah, first album.
Don't get us started about Happier Than Ever.
Don't get us started.
Started.
Although I did see a YouTube video where Black Engineer Road covered Happier Than Ever.
Okay, so I love the album now. Yeah. So I love the album now.
Yeah, this is amazing. Yeah.
Some funny lyrics on here too. Tell you that I'm broke when we're all alone. I can be a stripper if you want me to.
Yeah.
It's been a while since I played for you. Get a Switch and I'll connect with you. Okay. Never thought I'd be a gamer girl.
Wow, okay. So Jennifer B is a gamer girl.
Jennifer B, she's either a stripper or a gamer girl. There's two, like
whatever
she's got a dichotomy.
Whatever
you know?
You need. Yeah.
I would say like most strippers own Switches. Strippers play
Guys,
Animal Crossing.
We're taking a poll.
We're taking a poll. For any strippers watching
if
the
you
video.
Are, yeah. If you are A, is B true?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And yeah, and if you're just a gamer, tell us if you're a,
if you're
a stripper. We'll see if it goes both ways.
Yeah. Yeah. We want all of them in our community.
It's just a vibe-y SP.
Yeah. It is so like, I mean, lo-fi as well. Like it feels like they're just cooking this up themselves. You know, like.
Oh, yeah.
It's got that feel, which is great. Which is cool. Very impressive production.
Just vocals coming from like all over the place too.
It's like a. It sounds like a string instrument, but it's like.
Yeah, I'm sure that they are using strings and distorting them as well.
Yeah. Very cool. Title track.
Let's get into the greatest.
It's a beautiful track.
It was a good track. I love you, Jennifer B. That's how I feel about that track.
Yeah. Yeah. Quick outro.
Just a little lo-fi outro. In case you wanted more drum machine.
Lo-fi drum machine outro.
In case you want another lo-fi drum machine outro.
We can go into greatest hits. Let's let it transition.
Transition us.
Everyone loves those greatest hits.
This
you know,
is like
just...
the jockstrap greatest hits.
Yeah, yeah. I always thought that would be a sick like debut album.
I
bet it's
as
happened.
Well. I'm sure
I bet it's
I've
happened.
Never seen a track titled greatest hits.
I guess
hits,
not a track.
I can't say
yeah.
I had.
Like wild.
Chipmunk. And this 80s ass beat comes in.
No, I would love to be in a dance club in this.
Oh, yeah. I want to be in the Despacio.
Yeah, this has the Despacio vibes.
Just the lights going
Shout
crazy.
I heard people talking in Spanish recently, and they said Despacio to each other, and
like
just speaking. And I was like, do they know? Like, but really, they're just saying slow.
They're just saying slow.
If you know, you know.
If you know, you know. Shout out LCD Sound System. That's enough information to figure out what we're talking about.
This game could give me like a Caroline Polachek. Like,
yeah, I like how in this song kind of it sounds like she's like this song's coming like through the radio.
Yeah, and she's like sort of in the mix.
Yeah, and it's just like it's like a greatest hits song playing on the radio.
Cool. Yeah.
And then it comes back.
It's greatest hits, and I ain't trying to hide it. I believe in dreams. Do you?
For the first time, I like it when he's inside. Okay. Thinking about the next time he's coming around to mine.
Yeah.
I think she might be talking about sex.
Yeah, this sounds like a sample, honestly.
It sounds like a sample, but no, that's just our girl,
no,
Georgia.
That's great. No, you're just in like some club, like the boombox or the jukebox starts playing.
You don't know this song.
No.
You just some you song playing, but it's very familiar to you. Like, did they play this in your childhood?
That was really
it's the
cool.
greatest hit.
It's very cool.
Dreaming in the dark, fever in the night.
Yeah.
See you on the other side.
Yeah.
Just like generic, you like ethereal lyrics, you know. Goes with the vibe.
Or like 80s like dance greatest hits lyrics. It's amazing. It's almost like a period piece. Like
it
like,
is.
It's like what would Georgia sound like on an 80s greatest hit track?
Imagine you're on cocaine, okay? In the club in the 80s.
Ooh,
then we break it down.
Amazing.
Yeah. I love that.
Loop that.
Okay, so I'm gonna say
baby
chip it up.
Yeah.
Keep the drumming going.
That's dancing.
And then this section of the song is the strangest lyrically, honestly.
I love that.
That's coming up.
Yeah. Yeah, you're just like you're still dancing. Taylor's building a beat for you.
Oh yeah. No, I would love to see him cook. They're pretty epic live.
Yeah. Jockstrap DJ set. Hey, you got pianos in the mix.
Imagine I'm the Madonna. No.
Dressed in pink.
Okay. Yeah.
Gabbana.
Feather boa.
I love it. That kind of reminded like Fiona Apple, like she's packing the words in.
Gabbana, feather boa. Marie Antoinette. You want to know her?
Believe in dream.
I can't believe Marie Antoinette is still like a. Like, that's still, like, a person who's sought after to be. Imagine, like, that was, like, 500 years ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
She's still, like, a baddie, and nowadays.
Yeah. She still has a sick name, honestly.
Maddie Antoinette. Yeah, even if she was, like, a bitch, like, I don't care. Like, who cares, right?
Yeah.
Like, she didn't give the people cake or whatever, or even bread.
She didn't give the people cake or whatever, but,
like.
I think it's let them eat cake.
She let them eat cake?
I don't know.
I think because they killed her, they got to eat cake, maybe. I'm really not knowledgeable on this one.
I don't know a thing about Marie
Antoinette. We know that someone said, let them eat cake.
And people love to quote it.
Let them listen to Jockstrap.
Let them.
Let them play synths.
Let them love Jennifer B.
Let them love Jennifer B.
I love this track, honestly. This is sick.
It feels like it kind of
back to the 70s.
Yeah, feels like you're going, like it's starting out as like a disco track, and then you kind of had
it's got weird
some
moments,
house
too.
Moments as
well. Yeah, yeah.
And then you got that 2022 fucked up.
Yeah.
Throw some shit in the mix.
That fucked up drum.
And then
what's it all about?
We slow it down here. This is like I don't even know what the comparison is. Like a Fleetwood Mac track or something.
Yeah.
Someone on a hill
like
with
a
guitar.
Laurel Canyon.
This is a Laurel Canyon type beat. Yeah.
I mean, I guess these last two tracks both sort of remind me, like, you know, Angel Olsen, like, she also does,
excuse
like...
Excuse me, that's...
Well, she also does, like, those kind of period pieces, you know, like, she makes a song sound like it's from the 60s. Very sick.
I kind of like that this one doesn't get too distorted, actually. This one is kind of just like
straightforward.
A straightforward track.
What's it all about, my friend? What's the last 4 years been about?
My good friend, I noticed you, yes.
The hostess.
And I knew you liked me, as I was waited on.
That's sick.
What's it all about?
That, like, Father John Misty album from last year.
Yeah, the Chloe year. And the
In
the 20th century.
It's got that old...
Yeah, 100%. That's another, like,
sound.
Retro, playing on the fact that it's retro.
Pastiche.
Pastiche, yes. We've talked about that word on the pod before.
Yeah, it's one of the big words.
Yes. I put it to rest with my best, my good friend. Will it ever end? I wrote all these songs about you, and maybe you came through, but I never knew that I've been here.
Drama.
Holding that.
Hey, the Roaches, man.
Oh, sick. Shout out the Roaches, yeah.
Like big synth hits.
It's great. It's vibey. It's like a swayer.
Yeah.
There's still moments on here.
Yeah.
It's not 100% just a guitar track.
What's it all about?
I wish you'd just touch me, yet I still sit and wait. Yeah, I think we'd be great together too.
It's beautiful, yeah.
Lyrics on this outro as well. Hurting is one thing, but waiting's another. You got like yeah. a twang in
that
there too.
That was some twang, yeah.
Laurel Canyon.
Shout out. No, they make the most out of, I don't know.
No, it's a, this like, one's a simple track. Yeah. I feel like it fits very well in the track list. What's like, because what's after this? Glasgow?
Or Concrete Over Water?
Sorry.
Glasgow's a few tracks.
Yeah it's kind of like a nice like 2 minute track in between what I think is like two of the better ones on the album and two of the, like the more wild tracks.
Concrete Over Water.
6 minutes of Concrete Over Water. Let's Sounds see what language here. Is getting spoken here. Is it backwards? Yeah. It's backwards.
Okay.
Read forwards. That part says, "Towers blue and the sky is black. I feel the night. I see it. It's on my back."
I think what she just is about to say as well.
It's exactly what she says at the beginning of the track. Yes.
I love the first line. I live in the city.
The keys to the city.
Yeah.
Some love.
Oh yes. Love. Yes, love.
Key to the city.
Whoa.
Wicked City?
What's it all about?
They love a good city.
Love a good
city. I do remember listening to this as a single, and I wasn't like in love with it or anything.
Yeah.
But right off the back of like that last track, it kind of continues the vibe at the beginning here.
It starts slow.
But it,
the
it
European
goes.
Air, I swear.
Randomly ungrateful for grateful for a night.
Yeah.
That's good.
That's amazing.
Oh,
she gets high.
It sounds yeah. good as fuck. The water.
Like a bridge.
Literally, like a bridge. Simple as that.
Yeah. Fascinating.
There's really only, like, the phrase concrete over water, it can only mean one thing.
It's like concrete over troubled water.
Oh, true. Yeah. Shout out Simon.
Shout out Paul.
Simon and Funk.
Simon in the funk.
Simon in the funk. There it is.
Dogs barking.
Something like that. Cult initiation. It's hype. Either or.
Hi.
You can like feel it happening in the background.
Yeah.
More and more is coming in. Taylor pressing hella buttons right now.
I got this dog sample.
You got this.
It's perfect. That is wild. Like that's like pure house music. Like
it's like it's incredible.
God.
And it just plays so well after the couple of minutes of What's It All About
yeah.
into the first couple
yeah.
minutes of this track, and then it's
yeah.
huge build.
Hype, yeah.
It's just hype as fuck.
I feel like it's like the first like snare drum, like I don't know, like it I don't know, hasn't gone like full dancey at this
yeah.
point, but then it just goes all in. It's great. Beautiful.
Okay, that was enough.
That
Let's slow it back down.
That was
hype.
Yeah.
That was lit, Taylor. But could you turn all that off, please? We
Let's
need to
back.
Hear our girl sing.
Fully like comes to a stop.
Let's restart.
Yeah. Like heavy breathing. In
yeah. Some intense lyrics on here
wow.
as well.
Yeah.
I'm glad you take me as I am. Whatever shape with woman, man, black or blue, a filthy cheat I am.
You still come see the band?
Yes, we will, girl. We'll see you soon. Light and dark at once, never lonely, in holy matrimony. Metronomy.
Shout out the band.
Yeah, shout out that band.
Sounds sick.
Whenever like you can hear the vocals like getting kind of messed up.
Oh, you just like hear her playing the piano. Like
yeah,
it's cool.
No, it really is lo-fi.
Yeah,
like, it's.
I feel like we give Georgia a piano and vocal moment, and then let me Taylor go insane.
Let me fuck
for
this
a minute.
Shit up. I wonder what the recording process or the writing process
is
on a song like this. Like, they must be a bunch of different parts that they came up with and just kind of like interweave together.
Water.
I like this section of the chorus. I think you remind me of the night, but also the day.
I think of Italy, champagne.
Italy, champagne, Spain. Three places.
Yeah. That European air.
It's like, it's just like, you remind me of like pretty much anything. Like, I think, because I'm just always thinking of you, you know?
Yeah. Or you're just not that interesting.
Oh, you're not that, you don't have that many like defining traits. Know, like, you remind me of the night, Europe. The day, I don't know, Spain? Really, I just remember when we were standing on that bridge. Yeah. Like, that's all I really got.
And we're like, oh, this is just like concrete over water. That's all this is.
Next time I'm on a bridge with someone, I'm going to say that shit. Concrete over water. Am I right or what? You remind me of the night, girl, and kind of the day, too.
You remind me of, like, Italy.
Yeah. Here it goes. Let's go.
Are these, like, synths or anything?
I love it. We need the synth pack, bro. Taylor, we need the synth pack, bro. Yeah.
Here's the Jennifer B. stems.
We need the Jennifer B. stems for real.
For real.
For real. Let's be real, bro. Most of the
imagine this is like a Daft Punk's intro song, just like so
this, that would be hype. We could start doing
we'll pay
that.
Pay him good money for those.
we'll let this whole thing run for a full minute and a half. Yeah. And it's just us like going crazy.
Yeah, full minute and a half.
Let's go! It's the Daft Punk.
Like looking in the camera. Like,
gotta film a lot more B-reel. But like,
people are clicking off of our videos pretty quick.
It's weird. Everyone clicks off before the minute and a half is up. Even though the thing is so hype.
Yeah. Shout out Rough Trade Records as well. This is a Rough Trade record.
Yeah. We love them.
Amazing.
Cool.
This song is called Angst.
Yeah, we're already in the second half of this thing.
Damn. This is the first explicit track on here.
Whoa. Let's get into it.
This is plucky.
Fuck. Shit.
Angst.
Back in the canyon.
Yeah, no.
With Joni Mitchell.
Yeah.
Showing us a thing or two.
So I played this scale.
Back in 1971. I was here with Neil.
Yeah, I lived with Neil.
I was with Neil. We were playing.
Played.
Was it her and Jim Morrison that would go on walks? No, that was Nico. Right.
Nico, yeah.
We're not going to talk about
that. The conversation was those walks.
I don't even want to know. That's the original Jockstrap, though. Yeah. Nico and Jim Morrison.
Wild.
I would make that would be a funny shirt, too, actually.
The Daft Punks.
The Daft Punks. Or Jockstrap.
Yeah, that'd be sick. Send it into him. Angst.
My organs bob about in the dark, in a mustard mist, in my stomach vase, barely connected by the tubes. Just love describing your body that
it's
way.
It's dark in my eggshell.
Yeah.
If I would have a baby, I'd name her Angst.
And hold her tight in my chest.
Wow.
I did just get a funny text that, I don't know, do you know who Trisha Paytas is?
Yeah. I've heard news.
Yeah, she had her baby the same day the queen died. So there's a lot of, but her...
That's like a cosmic shift.
It really is. But yeah. She named her baby a Malibu Barbie. So,
I saw that.
You know, that's just...
That's pretty amazing. That's.
I think Angst is a better name, even if not a great one.
Next band name, Malibu Barbie.
Malibu Barbie is a pretty great band name. One of these days we'll break down Trisha Paytas' music.
Is she? Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, she makes that like was Jesus her thing? Songs. Okay. Yeah, she's got a lot of things.
Ooh, yeah. It's got like musical vibe. It's got like very very theatrical.
Mm-hmm. Whoa.
I don't even know what that instrument is. Is it like a mandolin or something?
Some sort of string.
Yeah.
You hear like the darkness like looming in the background here.
It sounds like a car.
Yeah. She pulled on my hair. Whispered in my ear, you fucking love, you love to fuck, to fuck it up.
Fucking listen to her sing.
Fucking listen to her sing.
That's
sick. It feels kind of wrong when she says fuck, honestly, because her voice is just so delicate. Pull the cord. This is wild, she said. This is it. This is madness. Don't you love it? I was like frightened when I first heard this, honestly.
The vocals turned up.
Taylor, turn that shit all the way up. And the sun
streams like, sped up. Heart of law behind the locked door. I'm ringed around your neck. He thinks you float, but you don't. It's an amazing outro.
Boom.
That's very sick.
He sinks, like, you float, but you don't.
This is madness. Don't you love it?
Yeah. little Titanic reference at
Titanic
the end
Rising.
Yeah,
is that
shout out Wise
It might
Blood.
Be if you click on it.
Probably will be.
Someone's gonna
say that. Yeah. Yeah, obviously.
Another reference. Oh, Her Love's Gonna Change is another reference.
Oh, that's another Wise Blood song. A Lot's Gonna Change. Yeah.
Good track.
I mean, it tracks.
That was a cool outro. Yeah, that was really
no, that angst outro. It like
yelling over
hard.
Like
yeah.
one note on the main
yeah, and
or
the vocals are definitely like sped up, like
yeah,
slightly, just slightly yeah. to like
no, it's
go fast,
turned
a little
up.
Faster, yeah,
raw.
No,
if you know it's what that instrument was in the comments, drop it. Of course,
oh,
and
that's
always,
our favorite comments.
We are fools.
Yeah, our favorite people. Comments are either actually. I'm gonna pull up a funny comment too while we're here because it does relate kinda to what we're talking about because it's about British music.
Yeah.
Here we go. Did you see this one?
No.
Read it. They said...
What video is this?
This is on Fontaine's DC. And it relates to what we're doing here.
I'm excited.
I'm convinced Americans will never fully understand British/Irish rock and indie. You're all way too hyper and childlike, focused on getting lit rather than listening and trying to understand the music.
You commented facts.
I replied facts because that's so true.
It's
like,
pretty true. Yeah.
I mean, when we're on pod, like we're just trying to get lit. Like,
we're hyper and we're childlike.
I can't deny that
the
much.
The whole point of the Daftonics is to get lit. Everyone knows that. Everyone knows
so
that.
We're getting blasted while we do these, you guys.
No, but like, you know, we're from like a place that isn't like, I mean, I don't know, it isn't like cloudy all the time. Like, we
yeah,
just don't.
Sorry,
get,
we have fun in America. We don't
sorry,
get.
Sorry, we have
yeah.
sunlight. I don't know.
Sorry, our cities aren't wicked. I think like our hyper childlike energy works a little better with this album, I guess.
I guess we come in contact with like the heavy. I don't know.
Yeah, even
we
though
loved
I
that Fontaine's album.
That Fontaine's album was good. Sick. We liked it, and I thought we had a good episode too. I mean, it got the rest of the comments
no,
were all,
Irish
were all
are a
positive.
Different breed. I mean, so. they come for us.
That's true. That's
good,
true.
Maybe the Londoners will be nicer.
Please, y'all. All right. Please.
Here's Deborah.
Here's Deborah. Hey, Deb. How's it going?
Pitchfork gave us an 8.4. I just saw.
Yeah, I hate. I do this every episode. I. Have the Pitchfork article pulled up to try and ask you what you think it got.
I could have. I mean, when you said best new music,
yeah, I realized. Yeah, I had already revealed.
To me,
that,
the threshold for best new music is like 8.4.
Is 8.4, literally. I've seen an 8.2 or 8.3.
Yeah.
I think.
I know you fuck with this album cover, but I really wish it was something like mystical and weird. You know?
Do you
what
wish
mean?
Like Jennifer B was on the cover?
I wish we had. Jennifer
I do. I mean,
B,
I also,
like,
but I
like
also do really
landscape.
Love their past album covers.
Yeah,
they are more bright.
Yeah, exactly.
With like the Wicked City album cover is an all-timer.
You love that.
That one's
that
an
one's
all-timer.
No, I love, yeah, like, I love, like, the Love is Key to City one.
No,
like,
I understand that. You could definitely get something a little more emblematic of the album.
Yeah. It's all good, though. No,
but
it's
this
like,
is just
it's
like
a statement.
Simple.
It's a statement, yeah.
This is our debut album, We Are Jockstrap.
Yeah.
That's what I love about it.
Yeah, I like that, too.
We talked about, on our last one, we just talked about talking at 77. This would have been a good album to just call 22.
Jockstrap 22.
Jockstrap 22. Fuck it. I love we just talked over like one of the darkest moments on the whole album.
Like, back a little.
Yeah, just run the whole intro back. The intro
oh,
is
yeah.
a
pain is real.
Pain is real and love is real, but pain is also These growth.
Synths are great.
And grief is just love with nowhere to go.
These are like
brain
synths,
hurters
yeah.
a little bit. Just
kind of brain melters. Yeah. Oh, this Ooh. Is like vibey dun, though. Dun, yeah, yeah. Dun, I'm just like. Ride driving into the sunset.
Oh yeah!
Like,
my eyes are closed.
I'm
driving.
The sun's about to burn me to death. Like yeah.
Just grief is just love with nowhere to go.
Yeah, beautiful. She really captures like so many, like I don't know, iconic voices. Like
yeah.
I don't know. I just like. I mean, I've mentioned already. I've already name dropped like 20 different like.
Yeah, honestly, this track has me. I mean, I just got Bjork on the mind almost.
Yeah.
Where like
Bjork season.
It's Bjork season. Like it's coming.
Get
excited.
Yeah. No, but yeah, like the moments of like no resolution, like no drums, like just like moaning
just
vocals.
Just your vocals.
It's very,
they,
yeah, it's very
they
cool.
hit hard.
Yeah. Especially when there's
like this
a dancey moment on the other end sometimes.
Those synths in the background, you can feel it building. Like, let's go. After the statement, grief is just love with nowhere to go, you throw down this beat.
Press Y for a party.
Go sticks to run around.
Hello, I'm Lolita.
I'm Lolita. I'll take you to the city and back down to Koreatown.
Very interesting.
Yeah, I guess this song I feel like is just like about, I guess, ignoring all your problems. you know,
yeah,
just going down to Koreatown, 5 stars. Let's party.
Amazing.
Press the like button down below to party.
To party, yeah. Press why? Press like for party.
Press like to party, okay? Press fuck it. No. Press subscribe to party.
Press subscribe if you like getting lit.
If you like getting lit, yeah, literally, you're at the in the right
even
place
if you're not
according
American,
to
it's all good.
According to that guy.
It's kind of a wet leg.
Okay, sure. Isle of Wight. They get lit there, I think.
Oh, yeah, in the Isle.
Did you watch a Wet Leg versus Nardwar?
I actually did, yeah.
So awkward.
It was sick.
So awkward. That's what it was quiet. So good.
Yeah.
We might have already talked about it.
The one, Hester. She talks so quiet.
So quiet. Her, like, normal speaking voice is like how Georgia sings.
Yeah.
This beat is fire.
This is, I mean, this is just... MIA on the mind.
Exactly.
So,
I was gonna, MIA is just on the mind because like, we talked about it last month.
MIA talking about partying over the
No,
speed.
I have to think I mean, that is an inspiration of sorts for them.
No, because this like this beat or not this beat, this like melody, this synth melody is very like I don't know, like has that sort of Eastern feel to it.
It does.
It doesn't sound
No, I think it actually I was reading the Pitchfork article. I think it is even a Bollywood sample on here as well, like similar to a few of the tracks on that MIA.
I don't speak to the guys that I pass in the Greek quarter.
Yeah.
Back to the door.
The war with the decor.
The decor.
Are you hearing that?
What?
No, pick up your phone. I think I know who's calling.
It's fun. Deborah has fun. It's also got like a very like 90s, like the bass. Like,
sure.
Just like early 2000s, like, I don't know, a grimy, pop.
Hello?
Grimy pop. That makes any sense?
No, ooh. I think, honestly, like, this track is where the MIA comparisons are actually, like, very strong.
Yeah.
Where it's just, like, early 2000s, like, fucked up that horn right there.
Yeah.
You hear that in 2000s rap.
Oh, my God.
Make it heavy. Let's go.
Absolutely bang. It's sad if someone's like clicking off of Deborah like a minute and a half in. Like,
oh,
I'm
yeah.
Not
I don't really fuck with this track. You're not going to get to this insanity at the end.
Yeah, it's such a fun mix.
Wish I could tell you what I wished for. Looked at the moon. Press X at the star.
Press Y for party.
Press Y for party. Press X at the star.
Yeah.
Just on a computer. Partying. Yeah. Hey, if you like getting lit, like this is the song for you.
Yeah.
Maybe that should be our like little intro on YouTube.
You like getting lit.
If you're hyper and unfocused and childlike.
An American. You know what a great American band I've been thinking about is LMFAO.
True. Should we talk about that?
Yeah, we should.
I think we might be too late for tenure because I feel like that was 2011.
I lay in bed late at night sometimes.
Just
thinking
about LMFAO. They like took over the world for a moment in 2011.
It was 2011.
Yeah,
damn.
So we'll have to talk about that in 4 years.
All right, sorry guys. Sorry for party rocking. Yeah, let's go to Glasgow.
I do love that the name Deborah never mentioned on that track.
No.
Like Lolita is the name mentioned. Perhaps like the idea is like it's a character named Deborah.
Yeah. I just love that whole line. Press Y for party. Disco sticks to run around.
Hello?
Could that be a Lady Gaga
I'm
reference?
I'm Lolita. That's
Disco
actually 100% a Lady Gaga reference. Which fits in right with like kind of what we were talking about. A little later than MIA. That's the same kind of party
sort of
music.
In the LMFAO era.
The same era. Same era.
Let's go to Glasgow.
I'm just thinking, what's the last music we talked about that even is American? New music, at least. I mean, we talked about
Animal Collective
and Interpol,
American.
But new music that's American? Oh, we talked about Soccer Mommy.
Soccer Mommy.
Shout out Nashville. Thank God. Glasgow.
I think we're pretty balanced.
I think we talk a little more British new music.
We go British American.
But I think that's just what, like, the internet likes.
Yeah.
I think that's just what's big right now. I remember listening to this, texting you. Glasgow goes. We got to talk about this album. And I think it's...
No, I mean...
These
it's
moments.
Very reminiscent of the whole album. Like, it's... Yeah, it's a good sample.
Where you get that folkiness.
That's
like,
Americana.
That's Americana right there. Yeah. But you can, like, feel what's coming in the background. As, like, more synths and whatever come in.
Just fully produced by Taylor Scott. So.
Oh, yeah. No, I don't think any tracks across here have any other names credited.
Wild.
So I'd like to believe there was no one else in the studio.
I hope so. Oh, yeah. Come on.
Fuck it.
Come on.
Soccer Mommy
Mac.
Time.
Soccer Mommy.
Low-key, this is Soccer Mommy and Oniotrix Point never wish they were jockstrap. Wow, low-key, on the low.
That's crazy. Yeah.
Wishing I was on the road. You tipped me off that Glasgow could be a place to go. I said to you, yes, but I probably won't.
I mean, this is so Nashville.
It really is.
Country rock.
But it's like ironic though. Like not ironic, but kind of, because you know what's going to come later in the song.
It's that Glasgow Americana.
Oh, yeah. Wish I was at Glasgow Music Festival right now.
Straight up.
Go.
Yeah.
I'll just see you at the show. I really like that part where it comes.
I know myself. It's a beautiful chorus.
This is just a great rhythm to it, honestly.
No, to me, like, it just, it's so, like, visceral, like, vivid, like, beautiful, like, Scotland, like.
You're on the shore of Glasgow.
Yeah. I just wish, like, that's my ideal album cover, I think. Like,
like a
mystical,
like,
Scotland.
Like, foggy as hell. Yeah. I think they're.
On a bridge.
On a bridge, yeah. Yeah. Over water,
on concrete,
even.
Yeah.
No, I think. But something like that would have gone.
No, this is more punk.
I'm copping the jawstrap bumper sticker.
You gotta.
Sure. You gotta. And if it doesn't exist, I'm making it. Like, yeah. I'll figure out a way. Yeah. It's kind of funny. Every time you think this song's about to go to one of those crazy moments, it returns to that.
Yeah. This is so funny.
You checked into a holiday spa, broke it off with your man, and left in the getaway car. The days went on, and I thought, this is poor rapport. Guess I don't feel that way about you anymore.
I'm not coming to Glasgow.
So, you know, I'm not coming.
Yeah. I'm not going up there.
About you anymore. That moment, that vocal moment there.
No, she could have,
feel that way about you.
She could have gone full, like,
just country.
Yeah.
Full Joni Mitchell.
Yeah, full Parton.
Full Parton, Dolly. Full Dolly.
Full Dolly.
I know myself.
It's fire.
Sounds good.
Kick drum.
This is actually you saying that got me hyped for the Black Country New Road show with Georgia singing. She is just like,
I wonder if I can cut to a song.
Yeah, we can do that after this one. We haven't cut away at all.
No,
we are 43 minutes into the episode.
We've been focused.
But
We've been
focused for once. All right. I read that comment and I was like, we need to focus this time.
Yeah.
We need to.
We can't be so hyper. What was the other word? Hyper and childlike.
Childlike. That hurts a little bit, but I'll take it on the nose. You know, it's all good.
It's all good.
Commented from Anonymous as well.
Okay.
It's, you know, fucked up. Show your face.
Yeah.
In that moment,
like, a little, I don't know what they are. Yeah.
Okay,
kind of like beautiful house music, like,
It's like
ad music
just
almost.
In, like, the deep background.
Yeah.
In that moment, I am so alone.
Yeah. It's great.
Yes.
Beautiful. Jockstrap.
Glasgow. Love that a band called Jockstrap makes music that can sound like this.
Yeah.
You never know what you're going to get when you click on an album, really.
I mean, that's just true. That is genuinely true.
Like, you got a band called Jockstrap, you could click on this and have absolutely no clue what you're going to get into.
Yeah, truthfully.
My first thought would be, like, punk band. Sounds like Turnstile, maybe.
Yeah, but then you see, like, one girl, one guy.
Okay.
British.
Yeah, I guess it's just going to be like a little like...
Oh, like a dance duo.
Oh, like a dance, an EDM thing.
Yeah,
like,
oh,
it's going to sound like Crystal Castles. Kinda.
Yeah. All right, so Black Country New Road.
Yeah, let's hear like a new cut.
Let's see here. I'll do one with vocals by... Yeah, actually, I don't know if Georgia has vocals.
Okay, I'm going to read this quote real quick.
But I'm going to go to a song called Geese that is written by Georgia.
Here's what she said about Glasgow. Glasgow's a great city, perhaps my favorite in the UK. Only downside is that it's so damn cold all the time.
Fair. This is lo-fi. It's like Geese.
Geese.
This is Tyler singing, actually.
Got you. It's all good if you lied to us, man. We don't care that much. I guarantee the new Black Country, new road music is going to be good.
It is sick. It's different.
Like, I'm a little sad we won't get to see those songs, those other songs live.
Yeah.
Like, hearing Good Will Hunting live.
It'd be crazy, yeah.
Would, like...
The place where you inserted the blade.
Yeah, hearing that live.
Yeah. Actually, I'm going
to... But...
Yeah. I mean, you can see, like, the similar songwriting.
Why does it low-key sound like Glasgow?
Yeah. What is it, a Jockstrap B-side? I'll cut to Dancers really quick, just to give you guys another taste.
Just give us some beats. I mean, if you clicked on this, you like BCNR. Yeah. So you're not going to be mad about
it. We're going to turn you on to this band.
Yeah, have you ever heard of this band called Black Country?
They're also from the
New
UK.
New Road. Yeah. So they're in another... They're not hyper or childlike.
Yeah. Very excited. A Black MIDI / Black Country Road.
Yeah, I mean, Black MIDI is obviously going to go crazy.
We'll rip.
But I'm just, like, excited for what Black Country New Road set is. Yeah.
Sorry, the audio is good. Pretty low fire.
I mean, this is a live cut straight off YouTube. Yeah. It's okay.
Crowd clap.
Crowd clap. I fuck with it. Taylor would like that.
Anyway, that's that.
We fuck with it.
Let's go to Lancaster Court.
Sounds like somewhere where Black Country New Road would play a set.
Sounds pretty British, if I have to guess.
I love it. I sleep in the east and I live in the west. Pound in my chest as I yearn for rest.
Voice is like so clear.
Yeah, it was a little different delivery there. Sometimes I think I might try that. It's kind of more like spoken word almost than singing.
Or like theater.
Yeah, true. Place where I inserted the blade vibes.
Yeah.
I run for the pen, but the mirror has me back in again. This song is theatrical.
Yeah.
You're right.
Lancaster Court.
Making love, sweet release, we're gone. That's similar to the Black MIDI lyric, actually.
Yeah. Which one?
It's the same lyric. Yeah. Going, gone.
Yeah. It's a connection.
That was my best Jordy Greep impression.
That was great.
For the time being. That was Greep.
Just plucking.
I know. Just those plucks. Keep me going.
So, like,
every time that hits, I'm like, I jump a little bit. But
I feel like you hear that in, like, black and white movies, like.
Oh yeah, yeah, no, it's like know. it's a 50s ass sound effect. Yeah. I run like a horse with the wind right behind. The gorse, it scratches.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what that word is.
I love this line, actually. I try to avoid my gaze, but when I catch that pervert, I can't look away. That's amazing.
Like, I'm looking in the mirror like, fuck you.
That pervert.
Fucking pervert.
Just keep moving
forward.
It's beautiful.
Great message. Yeah. One of my favorites.
No, it's just, like, so vivid, like, saw the writing, the words, like,
yeah.
Just so beautiful. Just keep moving.
It's like, just keep moving. It's like, it's kind of sung like she doesn't quite believe it.
She's telling herself.
Just keep moving. Sometimes this is what your brain sounds like, you know?
That sounded like the Arthur Russell cello on Psycho
Killer. Oh, yeah, on the Psycho Killer acoustic version.
Guys,
check out our last app. Check out the Psycho Killer acoustic version. I bet they fuck with Arthur Russell.
Sure, certainly.
Certainly. Any good music fan does.
Ooh. Just hear the strings.
I know.
Echoing. Amazing. I wonder if Lancaster Court, where that is. Probably in London.
First, like, what is a gorse?
Yeah, what is a gorse?
A yellowed flowered shrub of the pea family.
Okay.
Cool. Then let's look up where is Lancaster Court. Probably in Lancaster.
Right.
If I had to guess, but probably not, honestly. Literally, why did that give me no information?
Oh, it's in California. Okay.
It's in a lot of places.
No, just type Lancaster Court,
UK.
England.
Really?
It's
like,
it could be anywhere.
It
frankly.
Could be anywhere. Yeah, I thought that was going to be like a distinct place, but it really did not give me much information.
I mean, the internet hasn't caught up to its.
Yeah, I mean, this album's only like 5 days old. Yeah. So. Yeah, it was another just like full.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like almost exclusively the plucky guitar and her vocals, and then you just get those like.
It doesn't really have a like dance.
No, that one was not dancey at all.
Yeah.
But you did it the boom boom.
Yeah, no, that's sick.
It kind of sounds like the Law and Order, you know, like the intro to that. Yeah. Boom boom. These are the crimes. I don't know the speech. Other people do.
I don't know what that is, but if you know below, if you know, drop it below. Where can we get that sound effect?
Yeah,
we need it.
We need
for
the
our
stems.
Intro.
That's going to be our new intro. Let's go to the outro here.
Wild.
Oh, you said there wasn't enough dance?
Wasn't enough Gaga
wasn't
type.
Enough, yeah, true. In the bottle of jam is what Genius says the lyric is here, but I don't know if I agree.
I have 50-50 extended mix.
Yeah, they released 50-50 as a single last year.
Okay.
But I guess they're like, fuck it, like that's boring. We can't just put that on
extended
the album.
Mix. Let's, I mean, straight off the bat, like you're dancing. Like this is dance music.
We are in the club.
Yeah.
Aphex Twin up in this bitch.
Yeah,
you know how it is.
Hell yeah.
Just following up the previous track, or even the previous like two tracks, which didn't have any of this going on.
Now this sounds like a different artist.
This is a different artist. We are
amazing,
Raven.
Man. It's a great outro, yeah. Shout out UK legend Richard D. James.
Oh, true, true.
Yeah.
Keep that going.
Loop that.
Yep, one more time.
I wonder like where they play this in their set. Like, ooh. Jesus.
This song almost feels a little out of place.
Yeah.
Honestly.
I mean, like, that doesn't even sound like Georgia. Like, that sounds...
No, this is fucked up. Oh,
those drums sound amazing, though, honestly.
I gotta go. Gotta think about that. She's 50-50. She's not sure.
Should I go? Should I stay?
When you ask me if I want to come or not to, like, the club, I'm
50-50.
I gotta think about that. I'm 50-50. I don't...
In the bottle of death. It's, like, trancy. Yeah.
I know, this is... Like, you could full throw this on at any given rave, and it'll play.
Let's see.
Ah, A, oo, e, ah.
Yeah. The vowels.
The vowels. Ah, A, oo, e, ah.
Anything to fuck you.
Always trying to assess you. Anything to fuck you. Always said I wanted to. Text me when you want to.
50-50.
50-50, I don't know, I'm
unsure. 50-50. Got it. Will do.
I would absolutely love an album entirely of songs that sound like this from them as well, though.
Yeah.
That's the thing. But I love the contrast as well of listening to this in one listen and just getting like those two extremes.
Yeah, Lancaster Court into this.
No, it's crazy. Text me when you want to.
Yeah. Amazing.
Hear that next beat coming in the background.
Straight up like a DJ set. Like,
oh yeah,
songs changing slightly.
Woo!
Lord,
this one's good as fuck too.
I mean, it's like Machine Girl, like any
Fox.
Dance artist like that. Sounds very similar.
Sandy, it's honestly like it's kind of hilarious to end this album.
Yeah.
With this, the closing lyrics of the previous track were like, I feel so alone.
Yeah, yeah.
I feel so alone.
Let's
and it's
dance.
Like, okay, fuck all that. Yeah. Like, let's go to Koreatown or whatever and let's party at the Five Star.
Amazing.
Forget all your problems.
Oh, yeah.
Just go to the club.
Her voice is so fucked up in this.
Oh, yeah.
Like, it's so... goes hard though.
We can probably
5 minutes long.
It's 5 minutes. It's the extended mix.
Yeah, yeah.
No, we can probably outro. We can outro this thing. Yeah. I thought this is like probably one of the. I mean, probably a top 10 album of the year so far. I don't know.
Yeah, no, I'm into it. It's very, very interesting.
It's like a pretty debut album. Quick listen as well.
Yeah.
What do we got here? Like 40, 45 minutes, something like that.
Sorry, I was on the LMFAO Spotify page.
Yeah, so valid.
Just hanging out.
So valid. I do that sometimes too.
44 minutes.
Yeah, it's just a clean 44
it's
minutes.
A couple longer tracks. No, truly, like, it's always like, it recontextualizes when we like listen to the entirety of every song at once.
No, it changes how I feel about the
album. It's got a lot of interesting production.
Right off the bat, like the run of Neon, Jennifer B, Into Greatest Hits is like, those are like three distinct jockstrap.
Yeah.
Like that's exactly what I expect from jockstrap.
Jockstrap moods.
Like, yeah, that's what I expected based on the other EPs. And then you kind of like everything from like What's It All About to Glasgow, it slows down some. You get like just like heavy moments too.
Concrete Over Water is sick.
That's a really amazing. Good track. And I really like Glasgow as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Both of the singles.
Yeah.
And then Lancaster Court, okay.
Yeah.
And then the 50-50.
A fake like outro.
It's like, that's like the outro to the album. Yeah. And then they're like, oh, that's kind of sad.
Fuck it, 50-50.
Fuck it. Like, just throw the extended
like an hour
there.
Long 50-50.
That actually would have been hilarious. When you look at the album, it's like, well, this thing's an hour 42. Yeah, what the hell?
Yeah.
Listen through nine tracks. Wow, you still got an hour left. Oh. It's really an extended mix. Okay.
Yeah, very sick.
This album is good.
Yeah, shout out.
I'm willing
Georgia
to
Taylor.
I'm willing to say it. Yeah.
Jockstrap.
Great. Jockstrap, yeah. Up put your jockstraps on.
Put them on.
Go to Jocks Reno.
Shout out.
If you made it an hour in.
Koreatown, wherever your Koreatown is.
Wherever your closest Koreatown is. Yeah. Go party it up.
We want to go out with some Sorry for Party Rocking or something.
Yeah, that'll do.
Along those lines.
I think that's probably the move.
That cut?
Yeah, yeah. Just give it to us. But yeah, this album's a banger. I hope you guys hope we weren't too hyper for you guys.
Childish. I know how Americans
I know get. How Americans can be. I know what your feelings are on Americans.
Yeah, no,
out
we
there,
love
so.
You, Britain. And
I know
beyond.
All we do is talk about you guys.
Yeah, truthfully.
So.
But yeah, we're sorry for party rocking, I guess. I mean,
yeah, like, my bad, honestly. Right.
But cheers and much love.
Have a good one, folks.
Good night. I drink in my head and I just can't buffalo.